Shalom, shalom, shalom. There I go. There I is. Is that proper grammar? Wait a minute. Here I am. So once again, you're in the sounds of the voice of KAHANTAZADAQ. This is your horse walk. Welcome. Once again, you're not under the sounds of the voice of KAHANTAZADAQ, and this is your horse walk. Welcome to another episode of The Truth Will Make You Mad. Will make you mad indeed. And this is a message to all of the people out there, the Fifis, that have, you know, I'm talking about the Eves that have altered egos, inflated egos. Her coconut is too big and she thinks that she's a prize. Well, I'm here to tell you guys, she's not a prize. Justice Raheem is in the building. Shout out to him. She's not a prize. Many men go out of their way, off of their limb, trying to appease to Eve when she's not a prize. If you don't know me, if this is your first time hearing me, seeing me, then you know that I've been intimate with over 1,000 Fifis, 1,004 to be exact, right? And one thing that I discover is that her outer appearance, the way that she appear to you, the way that she, the facade that you see is not always her. She have you thinking that she's a prize. There's many Eves that only earn 30-some thousand, but they say they want a man making six figures or more. He has to be making six figures. And many of these Eves are overweight, average, at best. Some of them are obese, but she still has this insatiable desire to be with a man of high standards, a high value man, a man that's fit, a man that's making six figures. She has a false sense of entitlement, and a lot of men, the way that you get it wrong is when you start chasing her. So what I'm going to say, this is the message to all women under the sounds of my voice. You're not a prize, and you're definitely not the prize. I mean, and the prize. Statistically, when we look at it, 80% of the women, and these are facts, you can't dispute, want approximately 10% of the men. But so the way I see it, we men that's on our purpose, doing what we're supposed to do, staying fit, staying in the gym, intellectualize, you're highly desired. No matter what she tells you, she's not a prize. The thing I'm going to tell men is that an attractive woman, only you men under the sounds of my voice, because I'm teaching you how to be men again. In fact, order my book, A Spokesman for Men, Real Swagger, and Women That Loved It. And also order my book, hold on, I need to get somebody on here. Order my book, The High Value Man's Guide to Understanding the Modern Woman. Now, all you people, see, NKC is in the building. NKC, what do you think? Do you think the Fifi's the prize? Or am I, man, the prize? Do you look up to her? Or should she be looking up to you? Your thoughts on that, NK. Your thoughts. Oh, not the silent treatment again. Come on, you're not around your woman. You can't be, huh? You can't be, huh? Careful, are you there? I don't know what it is about so many guys getting shook over these Eves, but you don't have to be afraid, brother. I'm the one that's speaking. Let them come for me. I want them to come for my head. Because I speak truth, and the truth needs no apology. And a lot of men, a lot of you men in the sounds of my voice, you can't speak this because your lady starts looking at you like sideways. So you slide down on your seat. But I'm the man. Someone has to be the guy to speak up, and I'm that guy. And any guy that's trying to come against me, you're not even on deck. You're a disgrace to men. Why? Because I'm speaking out for men. There is no voice out there, no sound voice for men. You got a lot of so-called dating coaches. They're philosophizing things, but most of them dudes haven't lived that life. I'm about this life for real. They talk about it, I live it. They're talking about my reality. I had to talk to one of them yesterday. Carefoot fell out, man. His woman must be around. See, another thing about you guys, you can't be a man if you can't say what you need to say in the presence of your woman. That means she's in charge. You understand? Let's see what we got here. Got someone. Put your face on the camera. Get out of here. Put your face on the camera. Get out of here. And when you come on here, act like a mature adult. Or get out of here. This is no place for portraying theatrics. This is an adult forum. No place for children.
Shut up, bitch.
Look at that.
Shut up.
Cowards. By here, see, I want you guys to get a look at this. This is the result of single parenting. By here, that's single parenting right there, primarily raised by the Fifi. You understand what I'm talking about? This is exactly what I'm talking about. The youth is a product of their upbringing. That's the result of the absence of a man in the home. Now, how do you think I would respond if I found out that one of my offsprings was conducting themselves like that? It's a result of the lack of fatherhood. It is detrimental to the entire world. And a lot of fifis trying to turn their head and pretend it doesn't exist. They say, yo, it's your problem. You ran away. No, you can contain your mouth. You're not a prize. I'm going to tell you guys something, Bob. Want you to think these Eves are the prize? Go into their house unexpectedly, and you'll see how many of them live. It is ridiculous. Just because she looks clean externally doesn't mean she's clean internally. And if there's one thing that disgusts me is an unclean fifi. You understand? You say YouTube is on mute? Hold on, let me check it out, huh? My bad. Hold on, let me check it out. So they've been missing all of this? Let me check it out. I appreciate that big play. Let me check it out right here. Huh? Tell me if you can hear me in a second. Tell me, okay, there's the Zoom speaker. See, I see you're right. You should be able to hear me now. Can you hear me now, right? Give a thumbs up if you can hear me on YouTube, man. I just spent like 10 minutes and you can't hear none of this. On YouTube, that is. Big play, can you hear me now on YouTube? You should be able to. These guys are moving in slow motion. I guess slow motion is better than no motion. Hold on a second, man. Careful, get back on these. Hey, Shalom. John Brown, can you hear me? Because Big Play, apparently, he's too busy at work to respond. John Brown, can you hear me?
I'm working.
Yo, it wasn't you.
Nothing on YouTube.
Hold on a second, bro. He said my YouTube is muted, so you can't hear me?
That's right.
Yeah, so it's on my side. It's not on your side. It's something with this Zoom board here. You still can't hear me on YouTube?
Yeah, I have YouTube audio on right now, so the moment that it goes live on YouTube, you'll hear it. And Rumble, I have the audio on, and I'm not getting audio there either.
Yeah, so it's over here. Let me see something here, man. But I'm hard on TikTok. I'm talking straight through
Your TikTok's coming in 5x5 on TikTok. TikTok's great right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get rid of this. Zoom, it's right there. How come you can't hear me? Let me see.
I restarted everything on my end.
Yeah, it's not your end. It's over here. It's over here. Someone's been messing with my board. What about now? Because I'm seeing my mic over.
If you listen to my mic audio, audio. The moment you go live on YouTube or Rumble, you'll hear it double. So, nothing yet.
It's weird, huh? Let me see. Someone's been messing with this Zoom thing, man. I'm going to replace this with the Rode, man. What about now? It's blinking. Something's not right.
I'm looking. If it, you'll hear it on my laptop the moment that it comes live.
So yeah, I may not necessarily hear that.
Okay, well, I'll hear it. But I don't hear anything yet. I'll hear it double because I got both audios on Max from Rumble and YouTube. So when it comes through, it'll come through.
USB? Still nothing, huh? Yeah, still nothing, huh?
Got 10 people on YouTube, 9 people on Rumble. TikTok's popping off, though.
Shalom. Yeah. TikTok, I want to move ahead. Hold on, man. I'm trying to get this YouTube on point here. I got to get rid of this Zoom joint, man. For real. I'm coming here screwing with it.
Huh.
Let me switch it off and switch it on. I got to get a roll back here also. Let me see. So, the deal is, to those on TikTok that can still hear me, she's not the prize, man. She's not the prize. Nothing on YouTube yet? I'm getting all...
Nothing yet. Radio check.
It's weird, because I'm getting all of the signals here.
I'll refresh both of them. Hold on, the video's coming through. See what audio... Nothing, eh?
Let me look at some audio settings here because it said that should be coming through, man. Oh, no wonder it's muted, huh? Now you can hear me, what?
Okay, hold on. Let's
you see. Can hear me now, right? You can hear me.
You'll hear. Yeah. We got you.
The joint's muted,
huh? You're good. Come on. You're good. All right, we're clear.
We got 10 minutes of dead footage on YouTube, man. But I'm in here now, so let me start it over, man. Yeah, you could come back to YouTube, Kierfoot, if you want it, man. I'm going to drop the link in the room. Any man that's man enough to speak up, if your woman's around, speak up. I'm here to tell you today, she's not the prize. She's not the prize. I don't care how sexy, yeah, I'm going to let you, Kierfoot. I don't care how sexy she look. What? Don't be taken in by the facade. Now, I've been intimate with 1,004 women, no cap, right? And I've studied them. And many of these women, though they appear to be very attractive externally, when I pay them a surprise visit and see their home, the way they live, she's no prize, y'all. That's not someone you want to settle with. You say, yo, why this dude been with so many women? Because just like Solomon, I haven't found one that's really worthy. That there's always something, some skeleton that comes out of the closet later on. But I'm not knocking women, man. I'm just keeping it all the way real. I've even met women that was virgins, but they didn't have a virgin mind. Their thinking was already indoctrinated with feminism and talking about the Most High is working on me. Well, you know what? Let him work on you over there because I don't have time for it, baby. I don't have time for it. My standards are much higher than that. You dig? So, guys, she's not the prize. Let me drop the StreamYard link in the room. All of you that's on, someone, careful, drop the StreamYard link on TikTok. All of you that want to come in here, I'm going to give you an opportunity. Because I know you want to take my head, and I want you to go after my head. I'm that dude to say it. Shout out to my man, Melon. Native Maurice is up in the building, man. Shout out to him. So she's not the prize, Justice. If you could speak up, come on and speak. But don't try and take control. Sometimes you're trying to run away with the mic, man. Like a runaway train, man. You understand? Tone it down. Never hunger again. What is your thoughts on this? Never hunger again. Let me hit some more people. Let me get some Eves on, hey? Someone share that TikTok link. So she's not the prize. Her external beauty, don't be over you know, eager because of that, because a lot of these women, a lot of these fifis are not as neat as you think they would be. I tell you what, man. Talk to anyone that goes into a female restroom and you'll see how many women would beautify themselves up. But when you go in the background, you'll be like, nah, man. And that's what you got to look for, because if you settle, that's what you would settle with. Again, I'm not bad-mouthing no one. I'm just telling the truth, and the truth will make you mad. That make you free. Any of you that got a problem with this, a lot of you fifis, you know I'm telling the truth. You don't want to speak up. See, Eve have this secret code that they automatically lie for each other, look out for each other. When she's committing adultery, her partner call her and, you know what I mean, lie for her. If her partner's man call her, she'll lie to him, just make up a lie. I seen it in action. You know what I mean? I have cousins. I have a sister. I seen it in action. And I've been with plenty of Eves that was capping for their girl. And I'm like, yo, why you do that? And so you wonder why I ran through so many. It's because I saw that behavior right there. And I figured it out. This is why I wrote books on it. I wrote books on it, aunt. You feel me? I've written books on this, aunt. And she's no prize. You're hard-pressed to find a good Eve in this setup. Solomon said he couldn't find one. I'm like the modern-day Solomon, man. You could like that, understand it, believe it or not, man. Now, you tell me how the average Eve that's making less than the average guy, that don't want the average guy, she want a man of high status. She want him to be fit. She want him to be handsome. She want him to be a certain height. And she want him to be making over six figures. Meanwhile, some of these women are only making... See who this is for talk. Yeah, yeah, come back. I want you to come in here. Big play, where you at, man? You all gonna get this work, man. She's no prize. And K. There he is right over here. Now, she... What do you think about this, NK? The subject matter, man. She a prize or what? So you're in and you're out. You're in and you're out, man. If you're a woman around, man, just man up for this one time, man. Dig deep and man up, man. You dig? I know it's a scary thing, man, to speak out against Eve, but it has to be done, man. I'm giving revolutions, man. This is a revolution of her mind. Complete constructive change. The average Eve needs a revolution of her mind because it's been indoctrinated with feminism. And we're giving that right knowledge for real. We're going to put everything back into its proper order in accordance with 1 Corinthians 11, verse 3, and Ephesians 5 and 22 through 24, man. That's the order. And whenever you don't have that order in earth, listen, man, there's no equality in a relationship. Let me tell you men this, man. There's no equality, man. So whenever the man is not in charge of that relationship, you get chaos. And I don't care how many of you get in your emotions about that. She does not have the capacity to be a man in a relationship because it's against the man's nature, first of all. Even if he's one of them dudes that eat a lot of soy products that I call a soy boy, he still knows something's wrong, but he just don't know how to be a man. You dig? So all you men that's allowing Eve to rule you, man, you're not a man. You was raised by Eve, and you got like ways. You dig? You got them ways on you, huh? And this is why a lot of you trying to come up against me like the dude yesterday. He threw on his cape, man. He wanted to save her. But after he heard me out, yeah, I agree with a lot of your points. Nah, you do agree with all of my points. How can you be a man and not agree with these points, man? But I mean, nobody wants to utterly agree, because then that makes them wrong, right? So nobody wants to be wrong. But there's only one truth, right? See, either you're all right or you're not right at all, baby. You think? Justice, what you got to say on this, game? Justice, cooling, man. Come on. It's good with it, Justice. You're muted. Can't hear you now. His mic's acting up. Your mic's muted, Justice. Justice is looking like a brand new dude, man. Suave smooth up in this piece.
They intimidated by the title. I'm telling you, they're going to run away. They're going to repel.
Nah, they ain't going to repel, man, because of the title. The title's what it is, man. I don't care. Let me make something clear, you can't. I don't care to these fifis, man. It is what it is, man. Anyone that's supposed to be here would be here. See, that's the problem, man. You guys trying to cater to these fifis too much, man. Let them run away. They still going to get this work. Because guess what? They're going to take that vibration. Oh, they got it. I'm tell you what, man. Google Tazadaq. Matter of fact, I got the shirt coming, Kierfoot. You're going to be the first to wear one in Canada. I got it made yesterday. It says Google Tazadaq. If they type in Tazadaq, they're going to find out who I is. You think? Now, we ain't saying who I am. We're going to say who I is. You think? So I don't care about... Listen, man, what they think of me, King, Big Play, is none of my business. You feel me? That's what it is, baby. Now, they going to get this work. The Justice, what you got to say on this, man? If someone got a lot of background noise, can you mute that and let the Justice speak, man? Because they need justice, man. Liberty needs justice, man. So we got liberty and justice for all. You think? Come, man. That's what it is, man. Where's that noise coming from? Careful. No, it's not careful. Go ahead, Justice, man. The mic's yours, man. It's a hot mic right now.
It's an echo.
Now, Justice, you still can't hear you. Your mic's muted. Let's see, man. Yeah, your mic's muted, son. I can't hear him. Careful, speak on that. Justice, mic is muted, man. Got it. Careful, you're muted. What's going on here, man? You're muted too, man. How you doing, man? Let's see what's going on. I just heard Kierfoot talking, man. Let me check this out again. Let me check the settings out, man. Oh, yeah, yeah. All right. It's me. My bad. It's the speaker. Now I got you.
Go TikTok, man.
Yeah.
Man, forgive me, King. You already know what I'm passionate about. Just right now, man, on the platform, man, I consider to get a little carried away, so all I can say is forgive me, King.
It's all good, man. You know me, man. I be trying to light fires, man, to get reaction from people, man. You know what I mean? People love controversy. You understand what I'm saying? They love controversy, y'all. They love violence.
man, gotta, like, if my brother offended you, he meant to, but at the end of the day, we all love you. For real, but at the end of the day, you've been mentally tormented. You've been mentally and psychologically reconstructed to think that supposed to impose upon a man is not that way. All you gotta do is be selfless. If you love your creator, if you love your life, love the creator more than anything. And what the scripture says, let us create man. Everything around you, every single thing around you, all the way down to your hands, was created by a man. You understand me? Everything was created by man. You can look around, everything around you, me, small muscles up there, everything was around you, was created by man. You know what I'm saying? And it's just that simple. I was talking to her earlier. She was like, oh my God, I love how you talk to me. I love how much you love your creator, but I just don't want to share you. I said, listen, you share your love with the creator. The creator created for our man, period. And if we're not trying to boast, we're not trying to act like we're super better than that. We just know our worth. The Most High is going to bring that humble bread to us. Don't get me wrong, you rare women out there that's humble, that's submissive. that's open-minded, you know what I'm saying, that's willing to accept the Most High, that's willing to religion.
Now, hold on. Is that what that CMM glasses, man? Yo, we got on Cartier glasses, man? Yo, he living that, he about that life, huh? Now, he's stepping up in the game. They look kind of similar to my glasses, man. Damn, you see that world through a whole different perspective, huh?
Hey, you wonder where I get it from. You know what I'm saying? It's just a blessing. You know, it's just a blessing. You know, like, we are all men. Like, at this, get this in your brain, sister, to my, to our brothers out there. We are all filthy rags trying to get clean for our creator, period. And how we can get clean, honoring these scriptures, and ladies, allowing them men to be ahead. We understand that you've been tormented, that you've been traumatized by these wicked men out there. We understand that. We try to understand this system has done something wicked to them. Now, I mean, it's a psychological warfare that's constantly a domino effect. So you know where it stops at? It stops at you overstanding who you are and letting a man lead, especially when you know he's a righteous man. Especially when he's a man of the Most High. Especially when you know that he's on his purpose. He's not out there selling no poison. He's not out there trying to corrupt anyone. That he wants to be a God-fearing servant, humble servant for the Most High, period. And it's just that simple. It's just that simple. You got to understand, when you're trying to go deliberately against that, you got to step back and reflect on yourself. Like, why am I so angry? Why am I going against that? Because you've been trained that way. So you got to retrain yourself, like my brother's channel. You got to deprogram yourself to know that you are women to be the man's help.
If they're not coachable, they ain't wife.
Help that man meet his goals. Help that man be stronger. Help that man be more prevalent, more successful. You're here to help. You're here to help. Feed that man. Nurture that man. Be consistent with that man. You know what I'm saying? We're not talking that Sodom and Gomorrah stuff. No, we're not. We're talking about community, respectful, wholesome households, period. And if you know your man is unhappy, what the brother say, bring him another wife, I guarantee you. I'm giving you a prime example, right? You know that when you got your girlfriends over the house and, you know what I'm saying, y'all all congregating, having a good time, whatever, you notice how your man is a lot more joyful, you know what I mean? He's a lot more courteous. Hey, y'all need anything? Y'all want this?
Y'all check this out, kid. If you're a real man, I'm going to tell you how I get down. Well, if you're a real man and she got her girlfriend over there and they congregating and her girlfriend's single, she better be trying to make her girlfriend my wife. That's the kind of dude I am. If her girlfriend look right, it'll make that happen, babe. This me, man. I'm trying to tell you guys how to be real men. That's the best friend. Nah, man. See, I say what y'all think, but won't tell him. Because you're worried about reputation, man. I'm going to give it to him for real. What she should be trying to do is make her best friend my second wife. Because I need more women, baby. It's just the way the Most High designed me. And him too. Careful too. Justice too. They're just not being honest. They trying to win your favor. I'm not trying to win your favor. Because I'm the prize, baby. I'm the prize. You're not a prize. You was created for me. You got to understand that. As soon as you acknowledge that, that everything would fall in order. Because you're going to be putting things in their proper perspective, and then you're going to get treated like the beautiful princess that you deserve to be treated. But you got to get back in order, man. You warring against your man. You can't do that because that repels a man. It repels any masculine man. You understand what I'm saying?
Big con, and you're right. You know what I'm saying? Your brother right. I mean, you man, we just been so deep, you know what I'm saying? But thinking that, you know what I'm saying? We see y'all Eves out there looking good with y'all superhero pants on and y'all got y'all adornments all out, y'all got y'all head done all up. We thinking, oh my gosh, she's fine. But, you know, at the end of the day, y'all look good. Don't get it twisted, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is. But at the end of the day, let us create man and give him dominion over everything.
Yeah, I can't hold you, kid. But when I see a woman dressed like that, in public, that's right there. For me, that's an X. She's X'd out because I'm not about to try and change her. And if she what she's casting externally is a reflection of what's going on internally. So if she has a need to show her body to the entire world, then there's some form of deficiency going on in her mind. There's some form of insecurity that she's trying to compensate for, because women know things like that attract men. But the problem is they attract the wrong type of man, because there's no man under the sounds of my voice right here in his right state of mind that want his woman going out sharing his goodies off to other men. There's no man that wants that. The woman that's covered, God take her any day over the Sabbath, man. She's supposed to be covered in 3/4 of cloth, man. You know the science, huh? Do the knowledge to my wisdom, huh? That's the only way you're going to get a proper understanding, man. You understand? Sun, moon, and star. Man, woman, and child, man. That makes up the you and I verse, man. You understand what I'm talking about, God? That's what it is, man.
Oh, absolutely, right in the back, man. I ain't never lied, man. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, it's just that simple. It's just that simple. It's just that simple, bro. It's just that simple, my sister.
Real. Big play. You kind of quiet, huh? You're kind of quiet, big play. Careful, it has no words. His joint keeps freezing.
No, I like what you're saying. It reminds me of what Patrice O'Neill used to say, where it's like, a woman that'll get you another woman, that's not a 10 out of 10, that's like a 30 out of 10. We want 30s. We don't want regular 10s. We don't want 9s. We don't want rest of these lower numbers.
But think about what I'm saying.
Nah, it's on.
Think about what I'm saying. Women get emotional when you say that, right? The best person that she could bring her husband is a best friend. Why? Because they already have a good relationship. They argue, they make up. If her best friend is single, that's the best person she could bring her husband, because she knows she could trust the best friend. You understand what I'm saying? They don't think logically, man. I'm trying to think with logic via him. I'm trying to teach them logic. The best friend, you know what I mean? He ain't out messing with nobody else now. This is his wife. That's your sister wife and your best friend. Yo, that's a match made in Shemaya. You know what I told you? It's a match made in Shemaya. In heaven. Oh.
That's like, you know, that's what they call, you know, godmothers, Yahweh mother. That's usually your best friend. That's exactly who you would want to be.
Yo, that's coming from Big Play, man. You got a lot of noise in the background.
That ain't me. Oh, is it me?
Yeah, that's you, man. Staticky. Yeah. I'll tell you in a second, man.
Oh, he must have been closing the warehouse door. That probably isn't heard.
Still hear a lot of noise, man. You guys hear that noise? It's static.
Yeah, it's coming in crazy. I'm not on TikTok right now.
And then got delayed in the background, so that's why. I don't know.
Let's see, man. Yeah, I took him from TikTok. It's gone. You see? It's gone. When I take him off of TikTok, man. So it is him, man. When he's not talking, you need to mute that. So she's not the prize. That's the topic. That's the topic. She's not a prize. Many men are deceived because of her external appearance, right? A lot of women, they look really beautiful. Yeah, he probably last
one in
the shot. I want her to listen, man. She got something to say. She can step to the mic, man. She could get this work too, man. I seen her back there doing her hair. She's probably turning. Yeah, I mean, when a so-called black woman turn red, that's how you know they're mad. If they blush your forth through their skin, man. Anybody can get this work, man. This work is for anybody, man, that don't agree with the truth, man. Anybody can get this work. So, careful, go ahead. Keep on, man. Pardon me for cutting the knowledge, man.
Yeah, so,
you know, I don't apologize to no one, huh? Apology means substandard, degenerate.
Forgive me.
Go ahead.
Never be inferior, substandard. The first time I ever heard a game like that was from Patrice O'Neill back in like 2009, back when he was alive. And essentially, you're playing for keeps, though, because he was just telling you, like, you know, if you like the kind of woman you want is a woman who's basically batting for you. Like when you go to the bar, she's going up to other women and she's interviewing other women for you. She's conducting the interview because she knows you. She knows what you like. She knows what you like in a woman, the kind of qualities you like in a woman. And now not only is she trying to find those qualities, but she's going to find out who in this room has those qualities. Do you know? Oh, you have a friend? Oh, let me meet your friend. Now she's doing the work for you, and that's a good woman. That's the definition of a good woman, is someone who's on your team trying to spread the love in the best way possible, and that's someone who's always looking out for you, trying to find you a new woman all the time. That's the best woman. That's your, like, of all the sister wives you can have, that's the best sister wife, because that's the one that's always going out for new horizons. And again, like, I always thought of it kind of like as like a dating coach back away, like, what is it, like, that's 14 years ago I first heard of something like that, and that wasn't, and that was more just to be a degenerate, that was just to get numbers on the board. This is more like playing for like the best quality life that you could have, that she wants to be with someone that she likes to talk to, and that she knows that not only did she like to talk to, but it's going to get along with you, who, because you're the best person in her life. And so that's why she's trying to find a woman for you. And that's basically what this is getting to, is that what makes a good woman? Well, a good woman is someone who's not only your best friend, but is also trying to find you someone that she gets along with, that you can get along with. You know what I'm saying? And to instill those values on those sister wives too is, again, another great thing that we would love to see in more
sister wives too is, again,
Con. Great content. Shout out to the people in the chat. Guys, to know the stats, the statistics. Hit the Zelle, hit the PayPal, hit the Cash App. Let's go. Let's make this rock. And again, the more this message gets out there, how much better is the world for it? A lot better. A lot better. The more that Eve is on with this program, the better. The better. Because I get, like, the program that they're going with right now, it isn't working. You know, I see it all the time.
Trying to get upset now. Phone is so slow that the Wi-Fi, I don't know.
Okay, I'm going to bear with me for a second here.
Your reception, your mic, what have you. So this is the thing, man. A lot of women going around, and a lot of men buy into this, because you men that buy into this, you was raised by women. But when a real man comes along and start talking like this, it seems foreign, right? And it comes across as offensive, but it's the truth. And I don't apologize for my status, because guess what? I don't need nothing for any of them, because for every woman to say, nah, I'm not with that, there's always going to be someone that's with it. That's what I understand, man, and that's what I live out, bro. And the ones that say no, I wouldn't be happy with them anyway. So it doesn't, your opinion of me is none of my business. It doesn't really matter. And this is how more men have to think. If your woman is not willing to, like, honor you and respect you as a man, then she can't properly love you. And part of that respect comes to looking to you as a leader. If she thinks she's equal to you, that relationship is not going to be balanced. That's what Western society has told you. But that is not how things are supposed to be, man. You're supposed to be the head of that relationship. Okay, we got Kara on here. We got Kara on here. Like, let a real woman speak, man. Kevin, what do you think about the subject matter, man?
Shalom, Sister Karen.
Shalom, brothers. Where are we starting? I'm just coming in.
Okay, so, Kara, so this is what I'm saying. Like, the modern woman thinks that she's the prize, or a prize, right? A lot of men are misled by women that believe that they're a prize, but externally, the woman may be beautiful, but internally, she often has, like, a lot of things to deal with. And if you look into some of these women's homes, they don't even keep clean homes. They don't clean up properly. While externally, she may look very attractive, but behind the facade, there's a lot going on there. She may even have like personality disorders that she's been dealing with from her youth. That's what we're speaking on.
That was important what you just said. A lot going on. And a lot of people don't want to look into, even if it's going to talk to a therapist, there's nothing wrong with that. If you don't have your mother to talk to, if you don't have your grandmother, which families, you've seen, there's an attack on that, period. But if you don't have knowledge of self, if you don't know yourself and know your role, and what I mean by know your role, no, I'm not. When people say submission, they take it as you have to get on bended knee, or if someone starts an argument and you don't reply, that's submission. And it's powerful. It's very powerful. I watched my great-grandmother, my grandmother, and running a house at one point was something that was treasured and important. But now it's off balance. And because it's off balance, our children are. And that's my problem. My problem is our future, today's society.
Right. Come on. So most women might, you know, most women would be offended by that. Like the modern mindset of the woman is offended by that kind of talk. You do realize most women will look to you as a traitor. Any woman that speak out against the paradigm in which they're living is considered to be a traitor.
Well, see, this is the thing. This is how they're looking at it. I'm not speaking out against. I'm speaking truth, period. And I understand that people are not happy with truth, but it is what it is. And you're only going to find out much later, because I counsel women, and I'm sorry, but I do also stand with the women that get sick of hearing all the negative talk. I get it. But at some point, we have to ask ourselves, why is this happening? What can we do? Because we're the mature, we're the women. I'm 52 now. So I have to be that person that just says, listen, I get it. I was, because I was there. I was the hard-headed woman. It took my son showing that he wasn't getting his needs met in a relationship to really see from another perspective. And I think that's where a lot of us have problems. They don't want to put themselves in the other place. It's a lot of, I'm just going to say, actually, it's laziness. It's lazy. It's out of balance. I can't say that enough. And also, I don't see how anyone, and I dare someone to call me a traitor, when I don't appreciate that woman that says, you know, he wants to see the baby. I'm going to keep the baby from him. I wish I had help. I'm a widow. I wish, but by the grace of, by the grace of God, really, Most High, my son is not going to settle for this love that they're putting out that isn't love. A lot of it's either lust or it's insecurity. And if you can't be told anything, then you're childish. And I don't mean to sound brass. I kind of just talk from the hip. I'm a straight shooter. So if you don't want to better yourself for relationships, then don't. But don't expect one either. Don't have expectations if you can't deliver. You can't. It's unrealistic. And that's where a lot of the world is right now.
Think about that justice.
What's that? I'm sorry.
I was talking to justice. Justice, would you think about that? Justice, you still there?
Absolutely, King. Absolutely. I hear the sister, man. She hey, a lot of these sisters, now, I mean, going to think you're straight. But at the end of the day, it's like, it don't matter what nobody else thinks. You know what I'm saying? It's all about the truth.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's all about pure truth, man. It's real. You know what I'm saying? A lot of us been mentally, you know what I'm saying, trained to think, you know what I'm saying? You know, trained to be simps. You know what I'm saying? Trained to be suckers for real. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Devaluing our own self. For real. You know what I'm saying? We are pure voice. We are the essence. You know what I'm saying? Period. You know who we are. It's real simple, ladies. It's real simple. If your man is unhappy, at the end of the day, sisters, you gotta take care of yourself. Even if it wants to take care of yourself, you gotta humble yourself.
What else I wanna watch, Harlem?
That you really gotta humble yourself. You really just gotta be selfless.
And it's just that simple.
We're not trying to be overbearing. We're just trying to let you know what the truth is. If you want heaven here on earth, I guarantee you, the way you can see your heaven here on earth, bring your man another wife. Be humble. Let your tongue be smooth as honey whenever you interact with any man, especially a righteous man, especially a God-fearing man, a Yah-fearing man. Oh, praise is due to Yahuwah by Yahusha. You know what I'm saying? Like, really give praise for you having life. Speak the name. Speak that name. You wonder why you need you ladies out there, not to get off topic. You out there calling on seizure boat chair. Jesus. And you wonder why I ain't not you are speaking the real name. You know what I'm saying? That's like if I call my brother nominated the authorized representative, if I call him other than a Kahan, if I call him Mike, he's not going to answer me. If I call him Malik, he's not going to answer me. But I called Kahan. I said, Kahan, peace, King. What the King going to say?
Shalom, peace.
You hear me? That's because I spoke his name. I spoke the authorized representative name, period. So speak the name of the creator, and I guarantee you, ladies and some of my brothers out there, your life will change. I promise you, submit and humble yourself. I promise you, and your life will be long. Your life will be truly blessed and fruitful. Bring your man another wife. Be open to that. Talk to your man about that. If you with a man that he's a really good man and you don't want him to leave you, and you feel yourself wanting to be argumentative, you feel yourself wanting to be combative, bring him another wife. I guarantee you, don't go against it. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can sit down. That man will tell you, baby, I'm content with just you. Then, hey, so be it. You know what I mean? Then you know, so he's his own with that. But if that man say, you know what, baby, I think I would like another wife. I want another wife. And you bring that man, that wife, I guarantee you, your life is going to be sweet. You ain't got to worry about arguing. You ain't got to worry about being in a household, using all that profanity, talking, you know what I'm saying? And cover yourself up, ladies, for real. Being them 3/4 of cloth, you know what I mean? Being those dresses. Wrap your hair up. Your hair is for your husband. Your body, your adornments is for your husband. Wrap it up. You can still look good out there without showing off every curve of your body. It is what it is. You can still look attractive. I think the most attractive thing in the world for a woman to be in a dress, for a woman have her hair wrapped up, that is the most attractive thing in the world to me. That is so awesome. You hear me? So no, get there. Keep the most high in mind when you out there conducting yourself, sisters. You know what I'm saying? For real. To these brothers out there, flat out, man, you know what it is, man. You are the prize. You know what I'm saying? I didn't say it. The most high said it. He said, let us create man. He ain't say nothing about woman. He ain't say nothing about nothing else. He said, let us create man and make him after our image and after our likeness. Just that right there speaks value. And another thing we keep giving. Look at everything around you and man stay created. We help you to create. We help you procreate. You understand? Girl, what the sister said.
Don't get it twisted, though. We love women, man. Don't misunderstand that. We love women in their right mindset, man.
We love women in their
real right women, mindset. Real women, man.
If I can just interject,
please,
the most important thing too is we need men to also stand up and lead. I noticed that the Generation Z, as I said, she has to feel safe. When a woman feels, I'm speaking from a traditional, yes, of course, I was raised that way. But when a woman feels safe, that is such a good and balanced love. Like, you're his peace, he's the warrior and takes away all the big bad dreams. You know, it's sad that people aren't happy about being someone's wife. It's not even favored today. It's not pushed. But at the same time, if you choose the different life that you claim, the bad, the boss, the all of that, then be able to take all the blowback that comes with it. That's all that I'm going to say. Like, I've noticed that people, like, some women are prone to expecting people to just be on board with whatever they say. No one has to do that. The Most High says all in the end. Like, humble yourself in that aspect, spiritually. Peace.
All right, Justice, unless you got something else to say, I think I'm going to end it right here.
Come on, you got to do what you got to do, King. You know what I'm saying? Most I willing. To all the sisters out there, if you really want to be happy, if you really are, like I said, if you really want your heaven here on earth, and you want to do away with all that vanity, you want to do away with all that negative vibration, and you really appreciate the man that's in your life, and he's a genuine good man, he's a genuine Most High fearing man, be open, you know what I'm saying? Love the Most High, be selfless with your love, point blank period. And with that, I yield. Shalom.
All right, so we're gonna say shalom. Everybody be safe until the next time, man. Get your minds